PHP 8.2 has been released in December 2022 with some new features. So let's see what's changed in the new version. PHP is an open source, interpreted, and object-oriented language for web programming. It has released version 8.2, and I'm gonna talk about the new changes with a bit of practice on them. This new major update contains some new features and a few incompatibilities that should be tested before switching on it. As the official documentation, we have read-only classes, disjunctive normal form types, null, false, and true as standalone types, new random extension, constants in traits, dynamic properties which is deprecated, some new functions, and some more deprecations. Performance improvement is mentioned, not mentioned how much it is. I'm gonna cover it in another video, so if you're curious about it, make sure to subscribe, then you're gonna get any further content that I'll publish. So let's have the new things. Here we have the read-only classes. There was an ability in PHP 8.1 to define a property as a read-only property, which makes the property could be initialized just once. So any further change not gonna be allowed by throwing an error. Declaring a class as a read-only class makes all the properties read-only. However, there are some tips to consider. Dynamic properties not allowed in any way. Traits, interfaces, and enums cannot be declared as read-only classes. Abstract and final classes are supported to be read-only. Only typed properties and just standalone properties allowed. Cannot opt out of the read-only status. To extend from a read-only class, the subclass should be declared as a read-only class explicitly. Unsetting a read-only property that is already initialized is still not allowed. But for an object stored in a read-only property, it still can get changed. In this example, the user class is a read-only class. So the address property is a read-only property. I have initialized it with an object, so I can change it. Disjunctive normal form, which is called DNF, is a standard way of organizing Boolean expressions to structure a Boolean expression into an ordered series of ands. With DNF, we can combine union and intersection types for type declarations just by wrapping the intersection type with brackets, and it's gonna work just fine. To get more details about it, make sure to check out the description. It was supported to use false as a union type in PHP 8.0. Now, true is added as a type too. With this version of PHP, it's possible to use true, false, and null as standalone types. We have a new random number generator called randomizer. As PHP.NET says, it more organizes and consolidates whether RNGs are available with the scope issues eliminated. It's actually an extension that is bundled with PHP. It's always available in PHP 8.2 and later via the namespace of random, with no runtime configuration to enable or disable it. PHP supports multiple pseudo number generators algorithms, which are called PRNG engines. Then we can pick one of the pseudo engines, such as Secure, or make a custom one by implementing it from the engine interface. Constants in traits. It's possible now to have constants in traits just like the properties. They can't get called directly from a trait, but we can call them from a traited class. PHP supports tracing the call stack, which is commonly used for debugging purposes. Debug backtrace and debug print backtrace are two functions to get the stack trace. When you have an error thrown, the exception object contains the stack trace up to the point of the exception. With adding sensitive parameter attribute to a parameter, it's no longer gonna be traceable. So with this new feature, we can hide sensitive parameters such as passwords or tokens from being traceable via logs. Alright, let's take a short look at the new functions. We have curl unkeep to check if the unkeep status is available for a curl connection or not. It's a mechanism to keep a connection alive by sending some traffic to an existing connection. MySQL execute query, which is an RCF. This is the sudo look. With this new function, we have MySQL prepare, execute with binding parameters, and get result. It's available for the OP version too. So in code, we can use just one command instead of those commands. We have OpenSSL cipher key length to get the cipher key length, which is in bytes. Memory reset peak usage to reset the peak usage throughout the lifetime of the request. Any parsed quantity to parse the quantity suffix for K, M, and G as kilobytes, megabytes, and gigabytes and returns an integer value in byte. New error log mode any setting to set permissions for error log file. Added curl effective method to curl get info to return the transfer method of a curl connection. And no capture modifier slash n support in PREC functions. By adding this slash n modifier, no named capture group will not capture by default. Let's talk about what's deprecated. First, dynamic properties is deprecated unless adding the allow dynamic properties attribute, which is used for std class 2. So with std class, dynamic properties is still be available, or we can use of the set and get magic methods to prevent any error. It's good to mention dynamic properties are not allowed for redundant classes at all. First thing, interpolation, if you're using the dollar sign before the braces, is deprecated. For embedding variables in strings, just use the dollar sign inside of the braces. Partially supported callables that are supported by call user function but not supported by directly calling are deprecated. However, for the above list, this is the way to fix them. Usage of the qprint, base64, uuencode, and HTML entities text encodings are deprecated for all mbstring functions. Also, UTF-8 encode and decode deprecated too. We have some bug fixes too, which for migration, we should consider them. The first one is ksort. For ksort, the bug was with the flag of sort regular before PHP 8.2. Alphabetical keys were prior to numerical keys, but now it's changed. STR split has been fixed for empty strings. It returns an empty array now, instead of an array with an empty string. So we can consider the output length 0. This is all I have for this video. There are some other minor changes that I didn't cover to keep the video short. But if you have watched the whole video, then you already have all the important changes. To get more about this release, check out the description below. I'll put some useful links there. For ideas, feel free to drop a comment below and tell me what you think about this new release. Finally, if you find this video useful, press the like button to support me and subscribe, then you'll get my next videos on your feed. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.